Hey guys, so yesterday we talked about how you can use tools inside your home to reduce your waste. Today we are going to take a look at my apartment, which I just moved into. So I went through and I had to get all new stuff and decorate. But when I say new stuff, it's not necessarily new. So I've been into thrifting for quite some time now, mostly because it helps your wallet so much. But I remember taking a course in college and that's what really made me want to switch to thrifting. It was a course that centered around what we can do to help the world. And a major focus on that actually wasn't living greener at all. It had to do with slave trade. So we know that some of the biggest issues of slave labor trade are in coffee, clothing, and chocolate. And for me, clothing was the biggest thing that I bought because I don't drink coffee. And while I do eat lots of chocolate, I don't buy it for that very reason. So I thought, what can I do to help not promote those companies who use human labor trafficking to make their clothing? And really the only thing I could find was thrift shops, because you never know sometimes where your clothing originates. I feel like there's so many middlemen nowadays. So to my great surprise, when I was interviewing this family about living zero waste, they said thrifting is a great option because you think about all of the energy and all the materials it takes to maybe make one single shirt. And you can save all of that time, energy, materials by just buying something used. And like we talked about in our last video, that's also gonna help your wallet. Most of this stuff, when it comes to living green, you're living more minimally and you are saving money. So everything in my apartment that you're gonna see has either been thrifted or gifted to me. So we're taking a look at my living room right here. And the couch, so let's start with that. So the couch, the table, and this console, I actually got on Facebook Marketplace. So those three things were all thrifted. And then if you look at those two end tables, they're little nesting tables, I'd call that a thrift gift because my aunt ended up giving them to me when she was done using them. So I was super thankful for that. Then we look at the pillows. The gold ones were used that I have had for quite a few years now. And then the blue ones were gifted to me by my mom. That corner, I love that tree. We actually found that at a thrift shop here in Grand Rapids. The rug and that corner chair were gifted to me by my friend Chris. Shout out to you, Chris Coons, you rock. I've had these lamps for, gosh, I would think since college by now, and I just keep finding a place to use them. This painting up here I got at a Grand Rapids thrift shop for just $13. I think it was about $13. And then this painting over here, like I said, some stuff was gifted to me. And my fiance did see me really loving this in the store, and he was so sweet and kind and did buy it for me. But yeah, I would say that almost everything in my living room apartment in general has been, you know, either thrifted or gifted. And I personally really enjoy decorating. You might look at this and be like, whoa, that's so ugly. That's not my thing. But I really like it. And for me, decorating is a form of self-expression. And I'm just glad that, you know, you don't have to sacrifice that when you're making these ethical choices and decisions. Because looking at my apartment now, I spent less and I still am, you know, helping the environment, helping the world while making my purchases. But at the same time, I'm getting everything that I want as well. I'm not lacking anything. And that's one thing that this family had told me. They said, we're happy. You know, we don't have a need that is unmet living this lifestyle, which I think is just so, so cool. So thank you so much for watching this video. I am going to be going over grocery shopping tomorrow, and that's a big beast. So we might have a bit of a longer video, but I'm gonna try and show you some of the ethical ways that you can go grocery shopping and what to look for. See ya.